MLB The Show has baseball coming your way from Tropicana Field here in St. Petersburg. Today, game three of this four-game series between the Boston Red Sox and the Tampa Bay Rays. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirshin here for this AL East matchup. Alongside are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And EK, let's begin by taking a look at what's led us to game three of this four-game set.
Yeah, it's been a...
And getting his final warm-up tosses in, the starter who they'll be up against, as you see his totals there on the right side of your screen. Him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. An inning in the books, no score on the show. And he will keep it going on the mound. He struck out the side last time through. Now the streak hits four in a row. One away.
Well, pitching like this deserves another look through as we check out the last four batters on show track. Here he was striking out the side the previous inning, and he starts things off here with another one. That's four in a row now. Pushed him up in the zone that time, and if you're expecting something at the knees, it's tough to go up and get that.
That'll put him into the hit column for the first time. It's a solid single.
Let's watch this swing in show motion. You're gonna see this pitch just tie him up in knots, but somehow he's able to fist it all the way out to right field.
And a softly hit ground ball. Throw on to first in time, one away.
And as we showed you in the open, he's out there putting his perfect record on the line. And so far, these guys haven't shown many signs that they're ready to put a one in that loss column.
Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line. Is over now, and he puts this one away in foul territory, and there are two men out.
Yeah, both these two starters are matching each other in the early innings, stride for stride. He's an out away now from a 1-2-3 bottom of the third.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Number eight, get a chance here in one of the bigger spots in the ball game thus far. Bases loaded now with two away. Now a fastball driven the other way out to deep left field. A leap, but he can't bring it back into the park. It's a home run. So he will touch them all on the grand slam, number 23 for him thus far, as they move on top 4-0.
Well, he was one strike away from getting out of the inning and putting a zero on the board. Instead, leaves one out over the plate. He probably knew it was trouble when it left his hand, and they wind up putting four on them,
especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
And he struck him out, and that's eight strikeouts thus far.
Now after the four-run inning, we'll get to see if he approaches things any differently now that he's working with the lead. Now you figure the approach will be similar, but...
The next 3-2. Big swing there as it's hit pretty well out toward deep left field. And this will be taken in out there just a few steps in front of the track, and there aren't two away now.
Man, not only has he not allowed a hit to this point, but he's also faced the minimum so far. You can't do much better than that.
Sets the 2-2 pitch. Goes down and gets it as this is bounced to short. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Rays. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Harry Potter will dig in with Sox on every base and two men out. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. That's in there. Base hit. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. The tag, and he is out at the plate as two runs score, but not the third. So it's two runs on one hit, no errors, and one man left on. Last half of the fifth coming up. The Red Sox lead it 6-0. And he gets under the 2-2 a bit as this is sent in the air out to straightaway central. Pulse, patrolling center, makes the play, one out.
Yep, another good job right there to get that first out. And you can pretty much bet he's probably thinking to himself, anytime my boys give me six runs of support, I think we're going to be okay.
I got the high fastball there, and he popped it straight up, way up there on the infield. And there's out number two.
Oh, no.
Still a little early to start talking about these things. There you go, right there. A big goose egg in that hit column, worth keeping in mind as we get later into the afternoon. Now a swing, and he pops him up, right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate. Pulse will put this one away, and the side is retired. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. They still find themselves down, 6-0. Number 8 will stand in yet again, and if you weren't with us earlier, let's take another look. This was back in the fourth inning with the bases loaded. A grand slam and definitely the big blow of the ball game so far. Belted into right center, and they're not going to have a shot at this one. This could be extra bases. Around second now, heading for third. The relay, but he is in there with a triple.
And if he's maybe thinking about the cycle, he's got the two hardest parts out of the way now. After the home run earlier, he's into third here with a triple.
A fastball that swung on and lifted down the left field line. Brewster moves over near the line as he puts it away for the first out of the inning.
And all through this winning streak of theirs, we've seen some great starting pitching, and this has been another very good performance. Good enough to most likely keep that winning streak going.
Here's a swing, and he saws him off here as his ball's popped into the air. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
Boy, that's some movement out there on the mound. You see that as a righty, he'll naturally fall off a bit to the first base side of the mound, and he just...
And he struck him out, so it might be time to begin the countdown as he's now gone through six innings without allowing a base hit. Down in order go the Rays. They need to get something cooking here. It's 7-0. And he strikes him out here. So that's out number one here in the seventh as he continues to keep him out of the hit column. Got him. So that's the second out of the inning. And he's 7 outs away now. Two. And he's struck him out for the first out of the inning, but perhaps more importantly, he's 5 outs away now.
And just another outstanding pitch right there. And it's not easy to do with so much on the line here in the eighth inning. And he's now down to his final 5 outs.
One-two pitch is swung on and lifted in the air out to center field. Pulse is there now, and he has it, two gone.
4 outs to go, and if he's feeling the pressure out there, he sure isn't showing it. He looks like he's just out there throwing a bullpen session or something.
And this is swung on and bounced to shortstop. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. They're down by a touchdown, 7-0. Tom Pulse will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat. Oh, and he rips this one to first. And that's through into right field for a base hit.
This one's been an absolute disaster.
Just got to focus on the glove and trust what your catcher's calling, because he's done a heck of a job also.
Got him. So the magic number for a perfect game is now down to 2.
Oh, and that's a big first out. And it's nice to get that first one out of the way. He's not home yet, though. Still 2 big outs to get through before it's celebration time.
Hard toward short. Throw on to first will be in time to get Molina, and that's out number 2.
1 out to go. Can you believe this? Man, I wonder what's going through his head right now.
Now a big swing as this has popped up, and I mean way up there toward the right side of the infield. And he'll put this one away, and the Red Sox will add one more to their winning streak as this ball game is over.
That is absolutely dominant. I mean, what else can you say? 27 up, 27 down. And you know what? This is the first time I've ever witnessed a perfect game. So it's one of the hardest things for a pitcher in the world to do, probably the hardest. But we were fortunate enough to see it here, guys. A perfect game.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. Well, you don't have to look too far to find our Topps player of the game. I'd say anytime you throw a perfect game, you'd be a pretty strong candidate.
Yeah, I'll say he's a pretty good candidate. All you have to do is look at the line score. No hits, no walks, not even a base runner. These come along in baseball maybe once a decade, so this is as good as it gets, folks.